We want to find the centroid or center of mass of the region with uniform density bounded by the graphs of the functions f of x equals x squared plus 4, graphed here in blue, and g of x equals 2x squared, graphed here in red. To understand what we're finding when we find the centroid or center of mass, we can think of this bounded region as a thin plate or planar lamina with uniform density. When we find the centroid or center of mass, we're finding the point where this thin plate would balance. Looking at the image here on the right, this point is the center of mass or centroid of this thin plate with uniform density, because at this point, the thin plate balances. In order to find the centroid or center of mass given by this formula here, we'll begin by determining the total mass, which is equal to density times area. Because we have uniform density, we'll use the constant k for density. This integral here gives us the area. We should recognize this as the integral used to find the area bounded by two functions. And then we'll find the moment about the x-axis using this formula, and then the moment about the y-axis using this formula. Then once we have this information, we can find the centroid or center of mass given by the point, the moment about the y-axis divided by m, comma, the moment about the x-axis divided by m. We'll begin by determining the total mass of this bounded region with uniform density. But before we do this, notice how, because we have symmetry across the y-axis with this region that has uniform density, the moment about the y-axis will be zero, and therefore the x-coordinate of the centroid will also be zero. But we'll go ahead and verify all this by using our formulas. So the blue function is f of x, and the red function is g of x. Also notice the points of intersection here and here, where the x-coordinates of these points are negative 2 and 2. And therefore the total mass is equal to k times the integral of, again, f of x minus g of x, which would be the quantity x squared plus 4 minus 2x squared, integrated with respect to x from negative 2 to 2. Now notice how here we could integrate from 0 to 2 and then double the integral, since we do have symmetry across the y-axis. Let's go and just leave it in this form here. So let's simplify the integrand. We would have x squared minus 2x squared, or negative x squared, and then plus 4. Now let's find the antiderivative. So we have negative x to the third divided by 3 plus 4x. Now we'll substitute 2 for x, and then negative 2, then find the difference. Notice when x is 2, we'd have negative 8 thirds plus 4 times 2, or 8. And then when x is negative 2, we'd actually have 8 thirds plus negative 8, or minus 8. So we have k times negative 8 thirds plus 8 would be the same as negative 8 thirds plus 24 thirds. So we'd have 16 thirds minus, this is negative 16 thirds. So we have k times 32 thirds, and therefore the total mass is 32k divided by 3. Next we'll find the moment about the x-axis. So we have k divided by 2 times the integral of f of x squared minus g of x squared. So we have the quantity x squared plus 4 squared minus 2x squared to the second, integrated with respect to x from negative 2 to 2. Now we'll simplify the integrand. So we'll square x squared plus 4, that would be x to the fourth, plus 8x to the second plus 16, and then we have minus, this would be 4x to the fourth. Now we'll combine like terms. So we have x to the fourth minus 4x to the fourth, so negative 3x to the fourth plus 8x squared plus 16. And now we'll find the antiderivative. So we'd have negative 3, or negative 3 over 1 times x to the 5th over 5, plus 8, or 8 over 1 times x to the 3rd over 3, plus 16x. So first we'll sub 2 for x. So we'll have negative 3 over 1 times 2 to the 5th is 32, so 32 fifths, plus 8 over 1 times 2 to the 3rd is 8, so times 8 thirds.
And then plus 16 times 2.
And this is supposed to be an 8. And now we'll substitute negative 2 for x, so we have negative 3 over 1 times negative 2 to the 5th is negative 32, so we have negative 32 fifths, plus 8 over 1 times negative 2 to the 3rd is negative 8, so negative 8 thirds.
And then plus 16 times negative 2.
So to save some time, this comes out to k over 2 times the quantity of 512 fifteenths minus negative 512 fifteenths, which equals k divided by 2 times 1024 fifteenths, which gives us 512k divided by 15 for the moment about the x-axis. And this does tend to be the more difficult moment to calculate. And now we'll find the moment about the y-axis, and then finally find the coordinates of the centroid. So the moment about the y-axis, which we know should be 0 because of the symmetry about the y-axis, is equal to k, the density, times the integral of x times f of x, which is x squared plus 4, minus g of x, which is 2x squared. And we integrate from negative 2 to 2. Let's simplify the integrand. Notice if we combine like terms, we'll have negative x squared, then multiply by x, so we have negative x cubed, and then we have 4 times x, or 4x, so plus 4x. Now we'll find the antiderivative. So we'll have negative x to the 4th over 4, plus 4, 4 over 1, times x squared over 2. Notice how this simplifies. So we have negative x to the 4th divided by 4, this would be plus 2x squared. So when x is 2, we'd have negative 2 to the 4th. That's going to be negative 16 fourths plus 2 times 2 squared. And then when x is negative 2, we'll still have negative 16 fourths plus 2 times negative 2 squared. So this ends up being, as we expected, k times 0, which is 0, which is the moment about the y-axis. So now putting all the pieces together, the x-coordinate of the centroid, or x-bar, is equal to the moment about the y-axis divided by m, which would be 0 divided by 32 thirds k, which is 0. And then the y-coordinate of the centroid is given by the moment about the x-axis divided by m, which is this quotient here. Notice how the k's simplify out, and this quotient here turns out to be 3.2, which we see here on the calculator. So if we plot this point on the coordinate plane, 0, 3.2 would be approximately here. This is the centroid, or the point where this region of uniform density would balance on a fulcrum. I hope you found this helpful.